must be John Marston.
Sometimes.
I'm Jake. Your friends from Blackwater hired me to guide you.
They ain't my friends. I'm pleased to meet you, Jake.
I got the horses saddled up and ready out front. Mr. Marston, let's get. That's what you keep saying. Take it easy until we're out of town. Ain't no point in calling.
You city boys sure have a temper on you.
You don't mind, Miss Payne.
Who said I was a decent fella?
It's been abandoned for years now. Folks say it was built during the Mexican War. What kinds of soldiers around back then?
Why'd they leave?
Well, I ain't entirely sure. I heard they had to go up north to fight Indians, or maybe they got tired of being soldiers and went looking for gold. You know how things is. So what are you doing up at the fort?
I'm looking for an old friend.
Well, like I says, you ain't gonna find many folk around those parts these days. Those you do find are about as sociable as an ulcerated back tooth. I mean, I ain't one to judge a man by the company he keeps, but...
Well, he ain't been friends for a long time.
Are you planning on spending any time in Armadillo, Mr. Marston?
I doubt it. I ain't planning on staying very long.
Well, if you're fixing for some female company, you can do a lot worse than Armadillo. Fine as cream gravy they are. Not like Thieves Landing. Dang, those girls ain't even fit for a drinking man to hole up with.
I'm a married man, I'm afraid.
Ain't we all? The marshal who hired me, Lee Johnson. Do you know him?
I think I heard his name.
Says he got a telegram from some Blackwater big bugs asking for a guide. I guess it's none of my business.
That's right.
You ain't very talkative, are you?
Nope.
I'm just chewing the dog, mister. It's how I am. I don't mean nothing by it.
Trust me. There's things you're better off not knowing.
I tell you, Mr. Marston, those coyotes eat better than I do. Not far now. You'll see the fort when you get to the top of this hill.
Listen, mister. This here's what's left of Fort Mercer. Some gang rode in and took the place over.
So I understand.
This is where we part ways, friend. You have yourself a good time.
Bill! Bill, I've come for you!
Gibson! Come out here right now!
Go away now, John. Don't make me kill you.
Nobody needs to kill anyone, Bill.
You must think I was born yesterday. You always did think I was an idiot.
That ain't fair, Bill. You were as my brother. I've come to try to save you.
Oh. Do I look like I need saving?
Bill, please. They want to kill us all. I can help you.
Well, you never tried to save me before. You only seemed to save yourself.
Bill, I implore you think about this.
You implore me? You implore me. You always were one for fancy words. Oh. Well, things are different now, John. Now I'm in charge! No more Dutch! And no more you. Implores. I implores you to go back and tell them to send someone just a little bit more impressive next time.
Well?
Oh. Poor John.
Well, you're alive.
So it would seem.
So, how do you feel?
I don't know the polite word for it.
I do. Stupid is the word we use around here. What were you doing?
I was doing something stupid.
Well, you'll be okay. Once you didn't die, the doctor said you'd be fine. He got the bullets out a couple days ago.
Good.
It cost us $15.
I'm sorry, madam. Should have left me there to die.
Did you want to die? I mean, was that it? Was that why you went straight out to Fort Mercer and picked a fight with the worst bandit in the county? To die, Mr.
Marston. John Marston.
Bonnie McFarlane. Miss Bonnie McFarlane.
Well, you may be right, Miss McFarlane. I don't know.
Huh. So what were you doing?
Trying to give Mr. Williamson a chance. For old time's sake.
You know Bill Williamson?
Knew him. Long time ago.
Well, what was he like?
Dumb.
Just like you.
Thank you, miss. See my hat?
I have. And, what will you do now?
Now I'm gonna take my time and go after him the less kind way.
Well, that sounds very fun, Mr. Marston. Quite heroic, just like in those penny dreadfuls my brother used to read. Meanwhile, if you'll excuse me, I've got a ranch to run. Of course, if you're feeling better, why not take a ride with me later and help me patrol the perimeter? You can earn back some of that money we wasted on doctor's bills.
Of course. And thank you for saving my life, I mean.
Next time, Mr. Marston, I strongly recommend you don't try to lose it quite so earnestly.
I'll bear that in mind. figured it's about time I started paying back that $15.
I sure can use an extra pair of hands around here. Let's see if we can get you back in the saddle. There's the foreman's office. It's also where we lock up good-for-nothing outlaws, such as yourself.
I'm happy enough with my current quarters right now, Miss McFarland.
Hop on up. You won't bite. Yeah! Let's make a tour of the ranch so you can get your bearings.
Whoa!
Right is the general store. You won't find Parisian high fashion, but it's good for the essentials.
Very convenient. I don't think I've ever seen a ranch with its own store before.
And here's the corral. This one's for the horses. What do you think?
I'm no expert, but it certainly looks like a fine corral.
I suspect you've stolen more horses than you've broken.
Now, where'd you get such an idea?
First impressions are hard to erase. That's the train station. Things sure have changed since the line finally got finished, bringing in all sorts of new folk like yourself.
Is that such a bad thing?
Change is only good when it makes things better. Before we head out on patrol.
You'll get no complaints from me, Miss McFarland. Whoa there.
How about a cold drink, Mr. Marston?
Thank you, ma'am. Getting shot then riding a horse seems to take it out of you. I could use a rest.
Sure. Come on in. I'll show you the house and then you can sit for a while.
Thank you.
Mr. Marston.
Miss McFarland.
Remember me telling you about the trouble we've been having with rustlers and other undesirables?
I do.
Will you help me keep watch on the property line this evening?
Sure.
I want to see just who is trespassing on our land.
This is a fine weapon.
Come, let's head out. The country is really beautiful at around this time. Come on, then. Let's mount up and take a look around. Open and try not to get yourself shot again. Thank you, Mr. Marston. I feel a lot happier someone's along with me.
I feel a lot happier now I got a rifle.
Well, with your trigger itch and my feminine intuition, we should make quite a team. Thank you. again. Come on, let's get rid of them once and for all. Let's see that rifle. I want a couple of these for the pop. Plenty of ground to cover.
Yeah.
If it's not the rustlers stealing our cattle, it's the rabbits stealing our crops.
It ain't never easy living off the land like this. Maybe you should move to a big city, become a lady of leisure. Something I've had a little experience in.
Maybe Bill Williamson did get lucky after all.
Luck didn't really come into it, miss.
You're a useful man to have around the ranch, that's for sure. But don't think I've forgotten what brought you here. We'll do whatever we can to help you.
I sure appreciate that, Miss McFarland.
Mr. Marston.
Nice to see you.
Thank you for your help, Mr. Marston. Makes me kind of happy I saved your life. Get some sleep and I will see you in the morning.
Good night, Miss McFarland.
Oh, Mr. Marston, how are you doing today?
I'm well, Miss McFarland. Thank you. How are you?
Well, I'm fine. Thank you. So, how are your ribs?
Fine. A little sore, but apart from a couple extra scars, it'll be as nothing happened.
Good. Come in. You know, you never did tell me how you met that Bill Williamson or what you wanted from him.
No, miss, I did not.
Well, why not, if you don't mind me asking?
I certainly don't mind you asking if you don't mind me not telling. See, it's a complicated and somewhat pathetic tale, and By telling you, not only would I be putting your life in danger, but also threatening the lives of some people that I hold very dear.
Well, I apologize if I seem to be prying.
And I apologize for my reticence. Hope you believe me when I say that it's simply out of respect for you.
Of course, Mr. Marston. I understand that a city dweller such as yourself likes to have some exotic secrets, so us country folk are impressed.
I'm no city man, miss.
Yeah, but I saw you get on the train at Blackwater. You with those gentlemen in bowler hats?
I'm still no city man.
But I bet you can't ride, Mr. Marston.
I hate to take money from a lady, miss.
Oh, you won't be. I'll race you right now.
If it makes you happy.
We'll see.
All right, I'll show you how we ride around these parts. Yeah!
Come on!
On the count of three. Three, two, one, go! I trust you're not gonna be a gentleman about this.
You don't know me at all, Miss McFarland. Watch and learn, miss! I bet you're starting to regret your brave words, Miss McFarland. Would you like me to slow down? Come on. Come on. Should I wait for you to catch up? Are you saving the best for last?
Sure.
You know, you should go pay the marshal a visit in Armadillo sometime. I'm sure he could help you deal with that nice Mr. Williamson.
Yeah, I might just do that, Miss McFarland.
You do whatever you think best, Mr. Marston. How are you?
Good, Miss McFarland. How are you?
I'm well. Would you mind riding with me to Armadillo? I've got to get some supplies and I could do with the company.
Of course.
You can take the reins. It wouldn't do for a terrifying bounty hunter such as yourself to be seen driven around by a woman. Take the driver's seat. Come on. You're looking much better, considering you were almost buzzard food a couple days ago.
I have you to thank for that, miss.
So just tell me, have you needlessly risked your life since we last spoke?
No, miss, I have not.
Well, that's a relief. Perhaps there's hope for you yet.
I wouldn't bet on it.
Oh, there's always hope, Mr. Marston. You can't be a rancher in this kind of country if you don't believe that.
An admirable attitude, miss.
I suppose so. I can't think of any other way to stay sane, to be frank. What about you? Have you ever given up hope altogether?
Hope hasn't really entered into it. It's not really something I think about.
A peculiar outlook. I can't really say I understand you.
I can't always say I do either.
Oh, don't be so deliberately enigmatic.
I'm not, miss.
Yes, you are. You are being deliberately obscure as a substitute for having a personality.
I just know there are two theories to arguing with women, and neither one works.
I'm not even going to dignify that gibberish with a response. Manhattan it is not, but it does okay for us. Most important thing for you right now is getting yourself into Dr. Johnson's office to purchase some medicine. The first one's on me.
Thank you, miss. I'll pay you back.
I'm sure you shall. The doc's a good fellow. He saved your life, so be polite to him. Meet me in front of the general store when you're done.
Hi there. I'm selling some good tonics if you need them.
Thank you kindly.
Valuable business opportunity, like I was born yesterday.
Well, look at you.
This weather makes a man have a lot of trouble.
Well, thanks for driving me. It was nice to be able to enjoy the view for once, and the little company never hurts now and again.
You're more than welcome, miss. Least I can do. Thank you for the medicine.
Why don't you have a look around Armadillo? You can always take a stagecoach back to the ranch later.
I might just do that. Travel safely, miss.
Try not to get yourself shot. I won't be around to save you this time.
Partner.
very much.
I hope you keep protected.
Hello there.
Excuse me.
Hey, hey, you got a visitor.
Shut up, you. Now, what you want?
My name's John Marston. You wanted to speak to me.
I did?
Apparently so.
Why?
I guess because we're both in the business of the law.
You that fella from the train company?
No, I'm from Fort Mercer.
Fort Mercer? You them one of them Williamson boys.
Calm down.
Go on, shoot him, mister. Shoot him.
Come what? You getting cute with me, boy?
What's going on here?
I got me one of them Williamson boys.
I got me one of them idiots who give marshals a bad name.
Kona, put your gun down. You must be the man from Blackwater.
Yes, sir. Listen, that dog ain't too bright. But he seems loyal.
Jonah, get out of here for a minute.
Yes, sir, Mr. Johnson, sir. And you. Oh, I done seen enough of your hide around here, friend.
I think there's some school children down the way you can go and frighten.
Oh, hardy fucking whore.
What are you doing here, Mr. Marston? Apart from frightening my deputies.
I'm here to capture or kill Bill Williamson.
Okay.
Can you help me?
He's outside my jurisdiction. He's in the next county. Of course, Bill Williamson and his boys have tended to keep themselves away from my town.
So you're happy to have him out there?
Well, I ain't happy, but I also ain't suicidal. My job is to keep this town safe, not clean up all of these three counties. It's hard enough around here.
You know, I hear you speak, and suddenly I'm reminded of how some of the people I respected most in my life had a problem with authority. What's wrong with you?
Well, I'm sure you and your fine friends have enjoyed spending your time running around pursuing noble causes. My cause is to keep this town from turning into a living hell for the folks who live here. The whole world has problems, mister, and I'm here doing what I can.
Why? What's happening?
Right now? I got the railway, the people who pay my salary, trying to get me to turn a blind eye to them burning down settlements up there. I got a bunch of cattle rustlers out near Box Canyon need shutting down. Not forgetting the gang that keeps murdering homesteaders out in the backcountry. And I got a bunch of hoods over in the saloon, drunk, threatening to shoot up the whole town. That's all I got today. But it's early yet. Give me a couple more days. There'll be more.
All right. Tell you what. Let's go deal with them hoods in the saloon. Then we'll discuss Williamson.
Okay, boy. You're a persistent little cuss, ain't you?
Only when things matter.
Come on then, Marston. Follow me.
Who are we looking for?
A bunch of two-bit hoodlums, led by this fella called Walt. Goddamn road agents who prey on the stages coming in and out of town. Drivers and armadillos spend more time with their hands in the air than on the reins these days.
And you're happy to let them drink in your saloon?
Happy? No. But the way I figure it, better they're carousing in there than out robbing decent folk.
That's an interesting approach to law enforcement.
kind of hole he crawls into.
Mount up, Marston. Walton's our man.
He spotted you. Stay on him, boy.
I'm getting after him. Catch me up.
Come on. If Walton's as bad as you say he is, why don't we just beef him now while we got the chance?
Because that ain't how the law works.
Is that right, Marshal?
And alive, he can still talk.
Doesn't sound like he's a man to be reasoned with.
He ain't. But a few days of my hospitality and he'll be telling me what I need to know. Walton's gang's been growing fast.
Outlaw is easy money for easy work.
Chola Springs, Gaffetooth Ridge, these boys get around. Walton's a start, but there's plenty more where he came from.
Come!
This hill.
Over here, puppy boy.
Marston, I got you covered. Move up to that wagon. Behind the crate, Marston. Smoke him up.
That ain't nice. There ain't a man amongst you can take me.
Now move up to that crate. I'll cover you. Take that fella behind the rock, boy.
I'll put a window in your skull, Walton.
Now get to that rock. I'll shoot you some space.
Not a bad shot, Mr. Marston. Why don't you check in with me next time you're in town?
I don't want to be no policeman, Marshal.
Nor did I, my friend. I can promise you that. I'll see you soon, Mr. Marston.
Come on.
treasure here. You want map? I retire. Here, take map. You earn it.
Thanks, mister. I could use a little luck. I need it more than you now. Who did?
He's missing. He's only a youngster. My boy is missing.
Where? Who took him?
Them people in the hills. Them hills near Hanging Rock. They took it.
Can't the police force help you?
Oh, they can't even help themselves. Please, sir. My son is missing. I need your help.
If I find him, I'll bring him back to you.
What have you got for me?
No good piece of dirt. Thank you.
Sorry, mister. I got nothing but respect for the law.
You could cause an accident like that.
Armadillo 731. What is it with these things? Hello? It's a new line. Hello? Hello?
Sounds fun. What's happening?
I have no idea. If it's important, they'll send someone down like they did with you.
Suddenly, the world is full of theys.
Yeah. I remember when we first got here. We used to consider people from Dade County to be exotic. Now guys can get here from the Midwest, and they can do it in 6 days.
Things have changed.
They've gotten away from me. Hello? I don't understand it no more, boy. Honest goodness.
I'm not sure I do.
Marshall! 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 I've just been up in the canyon, spying like you said. I think I seen me a couple of them rustlers. I think it was the Ballard twins and a couple of Mexicans.
They up there right now?
Well, it was a group of four men rounding up Mr. Gulch's livestock, and none of them looked like any of Gulch's hands, so yes, sir, right now.
That sarcasm's most unbecoming, Eli. It's going to hold you back in life, even worse than your lazy eye. All right, let's go. You ride with us again, Marson?
Will you help me?
I will try.
It'd be my pleasure.
Well, I got a telegram from some federal clowns in Blackwater that says otherwise.
Are you some kind of vigilante?
You don't look like no government, boy.
I guess it's complicated. I came because it was made impossible for me not to.
You sure are a tight-lipped son of a bitch, mister.
I guess I am. I ain't gonna dig this hole no deeper.
Ain't you all proud and superior? Don't forget you need us more than we need you. Bill Weaves folded you up like an empty purse last time, if I remember correctly.
Simmer down, Jonah.
Listen to your boss, Jonah. There's a good boy. Otherwise, I'll put a hole in your hillbilly head and watch your tiny brain drain out.
I'll be honest with you. Marston. I ain't for all this government interference.
Believe me, Marshal, neither am I.
I try to keep the federal boys happy. I mean, we need all the help we can get. But what does a flannel-mouthed city boy who's never forked a bale of hay in his life know about a state like New Austin?
Nothing, I reckon.
All this manifest destiny hogwash, taming a wild land. Nearly there. Here and follow me. Head for the fort. Be ready, boys. We're probably going to be outnumbered.
And those bastards ain't short on firepower, neither.
Let's see how many there are. If we can take them alive, good. If not, smoke the sons of bitches.
Music to my ears, Marshal.
Pretty damn good shit, John.
Yep. Maybe we like 10 foot I thought we would.
Coming from you, friend, that's a real compliment. Quicker than that, pal.
Follow me.
Excuse me, partner. I ain't getting fresh.
Bridge looks clear. Let's join the others.
father twins got themselves an army.
Yeah, rustling's a profitable business, and they ain't short on willing recruits these days.
Why the man break his back working 12 hours a day for a rancher who can't afford to pay
him? The rancher can't pay him because those sons of bitches are robbing his cattle.
Yep, it's one of them vicious circle things the marshal keeps showing about. Look lively! They're all across the ridge! Push forward! We gotta get to the marshal!
Forgive me, friend.
Stop falling behind! We gotta push forward!
How can you fight, you dumb bitch? We should go fast with the marshal up here.
He's been giving them hell on the other side.
That marshal of yours sure doesn't seem to mind getting his hands dirty.
Oh, he ain't afraid to pull the trigger, all right.
And he's been after these rustlers for a long time.
He'll tell you he's all about the book, letting the judge decide a man's fate. But he throws out plenty of his own justice, too.
Hurry up. Stay with us.
God damn it, how many of these bastards are there?
These rustlers make me sick.
This looks as good a spot as any. Gather around and listen up.
What the?
Let's try to sneak up on them. The closer we are, the less chance they have of making a run for it. You better surrender. You hear? Are you gonna shoot any of these rustlers, boy?
Thanks, Marshal. We're indebted to you with our lives.
Just get them cattle back safe.
All right.
Oh, thank you. Oh, thank you so much. Thank you.
Well done, Mr. Marston.
Yes, well done.
Now, about Williamson.
I'll do what I can. You know, as you can see, this country is infested with all manner of scum.
Say that again.
Well, one other thing, Marston. Mr. Johnson, sir. It's Mr. Wes Dickens. He's missing.
Who?
Mr. Wes Dickens, the tonics merchant. He was due in town last week.
Oh, the narcotic and bat piss salesman who cons housewives out of their money with promises of eternal youth.
Yes, him, but I think you're being a little unfair. He's helped a great many of the county, and many of the townsfolk are really missing him.
You hear that, Marston? We just butchered a gang of thieves, and the town is up in arms about a missing snake oil merchant. I am so glad to be serving such a wise and respectable people. Come on, Eli.
Can I borrow this, Fred?
Charlie. He's a good one to sniff out trouble. Stay close to Charlie.
But we
you sure can tell a good Wendy.
No need for that, partner. I doubt you'll be needing this.
Howdy.
Without a care for the law.
Hey, howdy. He's just an underprivileged hoodlum.
Well, I'll be.
Why are these cards sticky?
Well, that's interesting. You'll believe anything I say because I'm white.
Uh-huh.
Got a fact?
I'm gonna call it. All ready?
Let's see what we can do with it then.
Okay, then. I'll place a bet.
I fold.
Now that's more like it.
I'm gonna check.
It doesn't get much better than this.
Big spin.
We have to get them people off that land.
Harley bears repeating, do it.
Give me a real card now.
Ho-ho! Come to Pappy.
Call you.
Turn. I fold. I knew it. I just plumb knew it.
I'll check.
That deal almost ruined me.
Well, I'll be.
I heard Mr. Wilkins got a damn tiger up in his barn. A tiger.
You bet.
Moving picture show is real good.
I don't know how I'm listening to that jibber jabber.
It ain't that complicated. Come on.
I see the way he looks at my wife.
Uh-huh. Not a fact. I don't like to say, but could you hurry it up some, please?
nobody bears repeating, do it?
Hello.
Bet.
I call.
Brayton. Hello.
You can't win them all.
Here's hoping these cars show an innate bias toward the right side of the law.
Always nice to see an old friend.
Good. Wake me up when you fancy playing. I'll call that.
Sorry, buddy. I think you wanted this one.
Think I'll check. Fair enough.
I'm in.
Let's get another hand going.
Somebody's throwing dust. This might tangle some spurs.
Think I'm
He's
gonna
just
call.
An underprivileged hoodlum.
Well, I'll be.
No, thanks. Wow, you're real sure of something.
I'm out. Well, that's interesting.
You're joking.
I need some money for the bartender.
I get mad when I lose, you hear?
I'm gonna call it.
I'm calling.
You'll believe anything I say because I'm white.
Uh-huh. Not a fact.
Would you look at that?
Check.
Check.
I know your game.
A fella carrying a now that's more like it.
Sure, I'll gamble.
I thought I had it. Ho-ho, come to Pappy.
I see you fancy your hand, sir.
We have to get them people off that land.
Harley bears repeating, do it.
All righty, boys. I wish you all luck.
Damn it. I hear Nate Johnson running for governor of New Austin.
Shit.
I ain't never heard of him.
I'll call.
I'll put it out there.
Stop. No.
Let's see what we can do with it then.
Watch your step.
Yes, my spur.